This episode is about sneaker collectors. And when I say sneakers, I'm not talking about my cheap Chucks from Ross. I'm talking about limited edition, rare, hard to find kicks and the people who love to collect them.
I'm a sneakerhead at heart. I started collecting 10 years ago. I have so much shoes that I had to actually rent out storage for them. I couldn't keep them in my house anymore.
That was addiction for me. Cause I buy them three at a time. My closet looked like Foot Locker.
Oh yeah, that's addictive. That's very addictive.
It's definitely an addiction. Collecting shoes is an addiction. It's a passion of mine.
I spent a lot of money on shoes, man, over the years.
How much do you think you spent?
You know what? I don't even want to know. To be honest with you. I could have a house right now, probably.
The reason I'm so addicted to shoes now is because when I was younger, my parents, they really couldn't afford it. So once I was old enough to start working, that's where my paycheck went towards.
It's a hobby. It's an addiction. It's a habit. It's a lifestyle. It's pretty much everything. It's like an underground culture for the sneakers.
For me, it was all about Jordan. And I think that's the main way sneaker collecting started to begin with too, because it's kind of like this convergence of sports history, fashion history, and like hip hop history all come through this channel of Air Jordan. Everybody had a pair of Jordans. Just growing up, it was like Jordan, Jordan, everything Jordan. I had a pair of Jordans when I was like 13 or younger, you know, 7, 8. Just begging my dad, yo, I gotta get them, because at school, people had them. They make me jump higher. Feels like I'm walking on clouds. I think every kid at that time did that.
You know, Michael Jordan is the greatest basketball player ever played, and his shoes were always fresh. You know, you could get a pair of Air Maxes and be cool, but if you had some Jordans on, you was the man. And that's like, everybody pretty much had them. They was real popular back then. They still are to this day.
I got married in Jordans in 06.
What Jordans?
The 20s, because it was patent leather and it matched my tuxedo and everything. Yeah, I got married in Jordans, man.
As a baby, my dad, he would always buy me Michael Jordans. So as a kid, I always wanted to be Michael Jordan. That's all I played in, that's all I knew. So when I tell him it was my dad's fault, he started all of this, he started the monster in this, and he says he didn't. He just said he bought them because Michael Jordan was the best player and I always liked him, so he would buy them. But as the game progressed in the shoe game, you had to keep up. You couldn't switch to going to like a Payless shoe. So now it's like I have to maintain that lifestyle, I have to keep them.
I own close to these.
I probably have about
250 pairs.
I haven't counted in a while, but I'm close to 70.
180 to 185 pairs of sneakers.
A little over 90 pairs of shoes.
I probably have over 80 or 90 shoes.
My daughter right now, she has 47 pairs of shoes.
100 to 150 shoes.
I would say about 150 plus.
90 pairs of shoes.
So let's do the math. That means that these 8 people collectively own 1,112 pairs of sneakers. And if each pair costs $100, then they've collectively spent a total of... Damn.
It used to be really fun collecting shoes, man. It actually kept me out of trouble for a few years, and just over the course of time, man, it just became really into money. It turned into just value, man. It just took all the fun out of collecting shoes, man. When I got my Kevin Durant nurse, man, I mean, people had guns out there, and I mean, people were trying to take my shoes from me, and having that shoe in my closet, I didn't even want it there. I didn't want that shoe. It was just like so ugly to me, man.
People collect organically, and then when the companies, when the corporate side kind of catches wind, like, hey, people are buying this stuff, collecting it, then they start feeding into it. And then it just creates this like back and forth where people who weren't into sneakers could see firsthand that there was a lot of money in shoes. Like, you could buy a pair of shoes for $200 and sell it for $2,000.
That's another cold part of the game. Now, most people just be trying to resell them, and that's why it's so hard to come across them these days.
I mean, it's a great way for little kids to make money these days, like kids in high school and stuff like that. But it kind of sucks for the people that really do want the shoes, who collect them and wear them all the time.
It's horrible. But you know, I ain't gonna even front. I got a pair of them Yeezy 2s that came out a few weeks ago. I was able to get a pair and I flipped them on eBay. I needed some dollars at the time, so I had to flip those, especially with the resale value being so high.
These shoes instantly went up in value tenfold. $250 retail, sold the same day for $2,200, $2,500, $2,800, $3,000.
And the first pair went for 90 grand on eBay.
But again, it's not so much about the shoe as it is about the story. A lot of people fought long and hard to get these.
They actually have 18 pairs of shoes, and there's about 19 of us out here right now. This is like no other camp that I've ever been to. We actually have rules here. You have to be here at the top of the hour. There's no ifs, ands, or buts, no exception. If you're not here for a random checking, that 19 guy's checking your spot and everybody's getting bumped up. In the 18 pairs of shoes, there's only size 8 through 11 and a half. And I'm a big person, I wear size 13, so what I'm gonna have to do for this shoe, unfortunately, I'm gonna have to buy the shoe any size. And I'm gonna have to find somebody to trade with. A size 13, I don't care if it takes me a year. I'm gonna get that shoe.
You love the feeling, the rush you get when you get your hands on something that you didn't have and you wanted. That's what sneakerheads really respect in the culture versus people who are doing it for money. People who really are into like having these like hard to find items just for the sake of having hard to find items.
Being a sneaker collector means that you have to genuinely have a passion for it. You can't do it because of the hype, because you think everybody else likes a shoe. You just do it because you like that shoe. Like you feel good when you put that shoe on.
My family, they think I'm crazy for camping out for shoes and spending $200 on shoes, but once you get that new pair of shoes, it's like gold. It's like you've won, it's the prize. Until the next ones come out, then you're back to the treasure hunt again.